The Indian ferroalloy industry in the organized sector came into existence in the mid-60s. At the behest of the Planning Commission, which thought it proper that instead of raw materials abundantly available in the country being exported, the country could build up the infrastructure where it could use the natural resources of ores like manganese ore, chrome ore, titanium ore, and produce value-added products like ferroalloys. The first phase of expansion of the industry took place between the late 60s and 70s, and about 14 furnaces with capacity addition of 178 MVA undertook bulk production of manganese alloys, ferrosilicon, and ferrochrome. The second phase of expansion was during the 80s. On product diversification, assimilation of advanced technology, and setting up of export-oriented units to earn substantial foreign exchange for the country. This resulted in addition of about 12 more furnaces, and the capacity addition during the 80s was about 308 MVA. The ferroalloy industry was thrown open and liberalized during 1991-92. As a result, a number of small and medium units having transformer ratings of 2.5 MVA to 16 MVA came into production of bulk ferroalloys, particularly in the state of Andhra Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, West Bengal, Kerala, Pondicherry, Goa, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Jammu and Meghalaya. Since liberalization, the Indian ferroalloy industry has truly become global. The ferroalloy industry in India has grown rapidly since then, with a significant proportion being exported. The industry's present capacity has crossed 2,900 MVA, and by tonnage, it is around 4.65 million tons. The products covered are manganese alloys, HC, MC and LC ferromanganese and silico manganese, ferrosilicon, chrome alloys, HC, MC and LC ferrochrome, silico chrome and charge chrome, noble ferroalloys, ferromolybdenum, ferrovanadium, ferrotungsten, ferrosilicon magnesium, ferroboron, ferrotitanium. Like the software industry that propelled India to global fame and made India the hub of software development, properly nurtured, the Indian ferroalloy industry has the potential to make India the hub for ferroalloys to the world. Already, the Indian ferroalloy industry is a valuable foreign exchange earner. With the earnings from sales of ferrochrome and manganese alloys, the industry has reinvested in the industry by setting up captive power plants, operating coal mines, ore mines which generate employment, and spending a huge amount on society by setting up residential complexes, schools, colleges, and hospitals, etc., in underdeveloped areas. Electricity generation by the ferrochrome and manganese alloy industry through captive power plants is also supplied to the grid, thus increasing availability of power in India. Also, being a large consumer of power, the ferroalloy industry is a large and important consumer of power, especially in the eastern and southern regions, particularly Orissa, West Bengal and Andhra Pradesh. It is estimated that a 50,000 metric ton ferroalloy plant supports around 750 families around the plant. That is a total of about 90,000 families by the ferroalloy industry in India. And these plants are located in remote areas where there is no other source of employment. Growing opportunity for Indian ferroalloy industry. The steep increase in power tariff in South Africa and China, coupled with increases in freight and labor, have decreased competitiveness of these countries and has resulted in a sharp reduction in ferroalloy exports from China, which has turned into a net ferroalloy importer since 2009. This presents an opportunity for the Indian ferroalloy industry to consolidate its position as a leading ferroalloy exporter to the world, after meeting the domestic requirements. With new facilities coming up, India has the unique ability to immediately scale up production of ferroalloys. India enjoys a freight advantage in markets such as China, Korea and Japan, which are large consumption centers. China in particular has shown nearly 25% growth in steel production and is still growing. It is expected that another 800 MVA to 1,000 MVA capacity will be installed and will be in commercial production in the next 2 to 3 years, considering the expansion in the present and new capacities coming up in the steel sector and also as export-oriented units. Other advantages include comparable power, labor and inland freight costs to major ferroalloy production regions like China, availability of technically qualified people and the domestic availability of ore. Indian Ferroalloy Producers Association, IFAPA, is committed to the growth of the ferroalloy industry in India. IFAPA is imbued with the philosophy that while individual initiative, enterprise and efforts are the foundation of a nation's progress, a cooperative and complementary functioning of the ferroalloy industry is needed for consensus in all its interfacing activities with various outside agencies like the government and other industry bodies. IFAPA is thus the sole industrial body that interfaces with the government, trade and other industry bodies, educational and R&D institutions on legal, tenurial, fiscal, regulatory, forests and environmental, all matters connected with the functioning of the ferroalloy industry on a continuing basis. IFAPA demonstrates an active concern for the impact of processes, products and services and insists on regulatory compliance and responsible production, use and product disposal. IFAPA aims at providing a watching brief on regulatory issues, environmental and risk management information and reviews of available data by independent institutions, and increasing cooperation amongst its members.